everyone, it's Lily again. I work with the U.S. Forest Service here in the Columbia River Gorge National Scenic Area. And welcome to Osprey Watch Part 3. So last week when we came here, we checked on our two nests and then we also found a third. So I've decided to give these nests each their own nickname. So if you remember that original nest that we saw last week, a crow came and visited that nest and tried to take some of the fish. So I'm going to nickname that nest site the Crow's Nest. And then we've got the one right next door to it, which has those teenage birds in it. So we're gonna call that the teenage nest. Those birds are quite a bit older and they're kind of inside the platform itself. And then the nest that we just found last week, where the bird kept bringing back chunks of moss, we're gonna call that the moss nest. So this way, when I'm referring to the nest, I'll say, you know, here we are at the moss nest, and you'll know in your head that that's that set of babies. So, now that we've got those nicknames for them, let's go check out and see how they're doing. All right, here we are back with the moss nest family. You can see the chicks have almost doubled in size. So there's still two of them, which is great. And they're starting to get a little bit of coloration on their backs. It's a little bit hard to see because they kind of actually blend in with the nesting material. But if you'll remember, last time we could only really see their heads and that little one moving around. All right, so it looks like we're here right at lunchtime. So the male just brought in a fish. You can see how active those chicks are now. Wow, it's quite a large fish. It's a good catch. So now you can really see how big those babies are. And they're sitting right next to the female, mouths open, ready to be given some food. Lots of good action today. The one on the left you can see is actually standing. So when the babies are born, their legs are really, really weak. And as they get older, they're able to actually stand up a little bit, but then what they do is sit back on what's called their hawk joint, which is that first joint in their legs. And they kind of sit down almost like they're kneeling with their talons in the front of their bodies. So we'll leave the moss family and we'll let them eat their lunch and we'll go head down to the teenage family and the crow family. So here we are at the teenage nest and one of the parents, that bird in the middle, just came in, flew in, and you can see there's one of the babies stretching wings, quite large. So there we see one of the babies doing some practice flaps. So at this stage, it's kind of called a brancher. So they're not necessarily able to fly, but what they're doing is flapping their wings to build those pectoral muscles. So once those feathers are fully grown in, they'll have enough muscle to do some sustained flights. That one parent definitely has quite a large fish. I'm wondering if he's going to eat some of it himself before giving it to the babies. And I believe out of all three of these nests, the babies that are in this crow family are the youngest of all of them. So it's possible that they're still kind of in that pancaking phase. It's hard to tell from just the tiny movements I see here on the left side of the screen. So this is giving you a really clear shot of that adult. You can see how standing on that platform, those feet are quite large. Oh, there's some movement in the nest. There we go. So compared to when we last saw them, the crow family's babies have grown in quite a few feathers. You can see that they're kind of less fluffy when they move around. And this tells me that those adult feathers are growing in. All right, we've got two babies that I can see right now. You can see their heads. There we go. That's a great view. Oh, there's three. All right, everybody's still here. Thank you so much for watching Osprey Watch Part 3. We'll be back shortly and maybe we'll get to see some of these little babies attempt to fly.